So in the last video, we set up a logger middleware to log the incoming request and also inject the logger to the request context. In this video, we'll start working on the handlers. That is, we will define all the functionality or all the business logic that will go here. Before we do that, we need to define a model for request. The request model will define how the request will look like or the incoming news request will look like. So let us create a model here. Model.go. Package is handler, so we will first create a type which is a struct and say type news post request body. So we have created a new type news post request body. Inside it, we will define the fields that will be there on the incoming request. First is the author. These fields are arbitrary, but when you're building your project, you would have to define the schema of the models yourself. So whichever data is needed, you will define the fields accordingly. Author is a string. The JSON key would be author. Title, that is the title of the news, again a string. So let me define the other fields, then we can go over them. So this here is the structure of the news post request body. First, we have the author, which is a string, mapped to the author JSON key. Title, again a string, summary, that is the summary of the news, again a string, created at, which will be the created at date. Content, which will be the actual content body of the news, then the source. These are all strings. We will parse them according to their types. Then we have the text, which is the text that attached to the news, which is of type a string slice. So that's all the field. Now on this, I'm going to add a method to validate the incoming request. In production application, it is common that you would use OpenAPI spec to define your API and then use a validator to validate the incoming request and the outgoing response accordingly. If we get some time, we could implement something like that, but for now, that is out of scope for this project. So let me create a function called news. So this will be defined on the news post request body. I will just say news. I don't think for now we are going to use it outside handler, so I can just make it a internal function or a non-exported function. It returns errors. That is the errors that we get validating the fields. Return nil if there's no error, but let us fill in all the things that we want to validate for the incoming request. So first thing is validating that the author is not empty. So I can say author not is equal to empty string. If that is the case, we will add the errors. Errors, since I am using a name returned value, it is already initialized to a zero value, which is nil. So we can do errors.join, passing in the errors, which should be nil at this point, and then create a new error, that is errors.new, or maybe I can do fmt errorf author is empty and say this is the value that we got, n.author. So basically what we are doing is we are not going to return early, but instead we will validate all the fields inside the request body and return the errors accordingly. Next, let us check the title. For now, I'm just keeping these validations simple. Later on, if you want, you can add some complex validations. Similar to what we did above, let's join errors. Say errors. This time the error fields may not be empty, so we are joining the errors that we get. Title is empty and .title. Similar to this, let us do something for the summary. Now we also want to validate the created at time. It should be a valid time string. So to do that, I'm going to use the time package. So if t, which is a valid time, time.parse for format, I'm going to use rfc 3339 and then pass in the string that we received from the request. And if error is not is equal to nil, we do the same thing. That is errors is equal to errors.join and then the error that we got from parsing. For now, we are not doing anything with the time that we get. So we will just put an underscore for it. Next, we have the source, which should be a source URL of the news. So we can do a similar validation for it. For this, we will use the URL package and say parse, provide the raw string. If error not is equal to nil, do the same thing and add it to errors. Errors equal to errors.join errors and then error. Now we also want to make the text to be mandatory. So we can do a similar check for it. Here, we are checking the length of the tags array or the tag slice, and if it's 0, we return an error. Now, we have validated all our fields that we want to validate. So at this point, we just return the errors. So that's it for the validation function. To make more sense of it, let us just call it validate for now. Now let's write some tests for it. Please note that the difference between production-grade programming and your regular project that you build from YouTube is of testing. So testing is very important when you work in a company or as a professional software developer. So I will suggest you to not miss the testing section at all. So to test the function, we will create a file model_test.go. We will do the same thing, that is move models to this side, close the sidebar, and then here we say package handler test. If you notice that package name is different, even though the files are in the same package. That is because Go allows us to test our functions with black box testing, that is testing our functions or method here like they were being exported or being used by another package. For that reason, we will also need to export it. So let's start writing a test. Punk test news post request body underscore validate. So we are testing the validate method on news request body. As usual, let us create a slice of anonymous struct which will define our test cases. One field that we need to have is the name of the test, and then let us iterate through the test cases to run them individually. t.run tc.name. This is here where our test will run. Let's go through the validate function and write the test cases. First is name author not valid or author empty. Then we have title empty, name summary empty, time invalid, then source invalid. So these are all our error cases. We missed one, which is for tags. Here we say name tags empty. So these are all our failure cases. Now the success case, which is, let us just name it validate. That's it. Now what we need to do here is call our validate method on news request body. The news request body will come from the test cases because that will act as our test input. We can just say request, which is of type news request body. You need to import it from handler.newRequestBody. Then we say expected error, which is of type error. That's our output. So we need to assert on errors if they are empty or not. So first thing we do is tc.request.validate, store the result into error. I can just say it as a bool expected error, which is of type bool. If tc.expectedError, but there was no error, I need to have an and statement. We say t.fatal f expected error but got null. Let me zoom out so that we can see the test cases. Otherwise, we don't expect anything. Else if error not is equal to, here we need to change it to this. That is, we expected an error, but we got nil. And the next statement should be error not is equal to nil. That is, when we didn't expect an error, but error is there, we say fatal f, or just say fatal. Similar to this, we can do fatal expected nil. But got error. So that's it for all our setup. Now let's go with the test cases. handler.newRequestBody this time. The first thing we check is author. So we can just send a empty body. And then expected error set to true. Title. This time we need to provide the author because we don't want it to error on author. Author test. Author. Expected error true. Similar to this. I'm just going to copy this. And this time summary is empty, so we need to provide the title as well. Test title, still we expect error. Let me copy this to the one below. This time we need to have a summary, but time should be invalid. So I can say created add. This is a valid time, but let's mess this up. Say invalid. Now let's copy this to the next case. This time needs to be valid. But source need to be a invalid URL. So valid, created that, and then invalid URL. Now let's copy this to one below this time. Source needs to be a valid URL. https://google.com, or maybe just say testnews.com. If you provide no tags, that is empty tag, it will just use the length of nil value for our slice would be zero. So our test cases should fail. And the final one is where we expect no errors. So we don't need to provide expected error because by default or the nil value is false. But this time we need to provide the tags. So we can do string and test tag. So that's it for our test setup. We are getting a problem from this statement because our logic is not correct. Let us just, instead of doing if else, let us just create a if statement. If tc.expected is false, that is, let us do exclamation mark in front of it. But error is not nil. We say expected nil but got an error. Save it and try the test case again. Expected nil but got an error. This is when we want to have a valid test case. So let me change it to error and just print the error. We should have done this earlier too. Test again. Title is empty, which it shouldn't be because, okay, we are testing for the wrong things. So here it should be if title is, author is empty, title is empty, we want to error out. Let's save this. Try again. And as you can see, the tests are passing. So that's it for this lesson. In the next lesson, we are going to actually write some code for the handler func. Again, testing is very important, so don't skip it. Until next time, happy coding.